have you played at the Bourbon? Do you recall?
I can't recall, like several times in different bands. Too.
Okay. Yeah. So out of all the clubs that are still currently open, because I know a lot of them are shutting down now, which kind of sucks for a lot of these indie bands, which is your favorite club to perform in?
Roxy.
The Roxy.
Roxy.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's interesting, because you know that's one of the places we've
like
never actually heard
Dick,
anybody
you
comment.
Do you want to say something?
We're treated right? well there.
What about you? What
you
do
get
you
drinks.
Think?
There's a backstage to like warm your voice up.
And, yeah. So it's so actually it's geared for the actual artist in a lot of ways, whereas some of the other places are not.
Yeah, like, so, yeah. There's not a lot of bars that have a place to chill out. Mm-hmm. Or
how do you feel about the Red Room?
We just played there.
How do you feel about it?
Great. Yeah, great sound.
Mm-hmm.
Good. What do you think, Kelly?
Yeah.
The Red Room, or
they have a good, like a big stage there. So
yeah. Talk to the mic, please.
Just yell at it.
See, these are musicians. They're like about. It's about the sound. It's about how they feel.
The quality of it.
Didn't have a very good
channel
for that show.
Yeah,
I think the great thing about Dick being at a show is, I don't know fuck all about music. I don't know how it sounds. I will watch the crowd. I will see who's drinking. Is the bar making money? Because you have to know as an independent band, if my bar isn't making money, you're not fucking coming back next time, you know what I mean?
Right, and so there's that whole pattern that a lot of people
I went and saw a band that is one of my favorites, Stampede Queen, at the Red Room, and fucking if I wasn't there drinking, I'm pretty sure the fucking nobody would have got paid that day. Like, it was just dead. It was just sad.
Yeah. And again, a good band.
Yes,
yeah.
An awesome band.
So, yeah. But I think that
more awesome live.
Yeah. I want to see your guys' show, because your show sounds trippy. And
do you wonder why not many people come out to see shows anymore? I think it's a lot of different things that are.
They don't have a driver.
Cover charge. You got so many different places to spend your money on entertainment now.
Yes.
I would go to
but
every
to,
show
honestly,
if I had
sorry, 10 bucks
a designated
it's
driver.
It's still freaking cheap to go for $10. Honestly. If I heard you guys, if I already knew your album, whatever, and I said, okay, listen, I love this band, I'd love to see them live. I would not flinch at $10. Seriously. That is like nothing.
Especially
thousands for a living.
No, but that's a pack of cigarettes. You know what I mean? Like, it's really not a lot of money to ask at the front door. Mind you, if the drinks are $10 a shot, I'd be probably not drinking so much, but you know, as a cover charge. And the reason I say that is because hopefully some of that cover charge is going back to you guys as the performers.
I always thought cover charge should go right
to the
bank.
My understanding is that it doesn't.
Do you book your own stuff, or are you hooked up with Clyde?
We book our own stuff. I book through Clyde sometimes.
Yes.
Just, you know.
You ever done a gig and not got paid?
Several times.
Why is that? Why did that happen?
Well, you can sometimes look at the venue. It may be a weeknight show or something, and nobody's in there. And you're not going to walk up to the promoter and ask for money if it just looks like nobody's getting paid.
Yes, yeah.
And some nights are like that, some nights are packed.
Right, and that's got to be so frustrating.
Scotty,
I
mean,
I have a basic rule. Nobody works for free. Nobody works for free.
Independent bands work for free all the time.
I know, and it makes me furious because you guys put your heart and soul into what you do. It's a passion, and you know, you guys aren't getting booked because you're shitty. Seriously, you got to be decent to be able to get up on that stage in the first place. There's people in the bar. You got to get paid. There should be just like a flat fee. If nothing
you
else,
you
got to
be your own roadie, and that's worth at least $10 an hour.
As indie bands, you guys have so much responsibility on your heads. You're self-promoting. You're booking your own concerts. You're writing the music. You're practicing. You're trying to keep the band all together and everybody happy.
People do not appreciate how much work is involved in making an indie band.
The mercy of the promoters, and that's where we are.
Yeah.
And if we don't like it, there's 10 or 15 other bands that'll go and play for free.
Exactly, I know, and that's what makes me mad.
If we
could
all stand up and just not play and demand it,
then where is the unity? The unity is right here. We're getting people to heard and realize that indie bands really need to be recognized. We pay to go on the air.
We're trying to create a community for the independent scene. It's not necessarily about Vancouver, but Vancouver will do for now. We want to do it for the world.
Yes.
The whole thing is, we're here, like, fucking, are you getting paid?
No.
You getting paid?
Maybe.
I actually paid a producer for us to all get to sit here and stuff. And I just think I got the greatest fucking hobby in the world or whatever. But I think that band's got to say, you know what, fuck you, we're not going to go do the show and not get paid. Let's get this done. Let's get, like Clyde, I had a conversation with him on Wednesday and the voodoo thing, I'm not going to fucking bore everybody with it or whatever. But get paid, man. It's bullshit. You're musicians, you're artists, you're bringing your techno, like you're bringing like your screens.
Just
you're,
loading
I'm
the
going
gear.
To show. I don't even like the apartment. The I'm going to bring my ID so this fucker's going to see me next time. I'm going to see you on Friday. I want to see the show.
Yep.
I just don't, all I was saying is I don't agree with the way the whole setup is, but I don't give a shit. If you guys are going to sound good, I'll be there. I got fucking nothing else to do.
Okay, and so also, that's true.